Hello, I'm Héloïse Brion from Miss Maggie's Kitchen, and I'm very happy to spend some time with you today here on Cézanne to share with you two of my very typically French recipes. The roasted chicken that we usually do on Sundays, but it's delicious any day of the week, and mashed potatoes, but with infused crème fraîche, which is sour cream and herbs from the garden and garlic and all the good things. First, I'd like to show you all the ingredients and then we'll walk through the recipe. So we need to have a nice farmer's market chicken. This one is about 2 kilos, okay? And then I have about 1.5 kilos, which is almost 3 pounds, I think, of potatoes. We have some lemons. We have 2 heads of garlic, olive oil, of course, pepper, and I have salt in here. We have some butter, and then from the garden I have fresh oregano, thyme, and rosemary, and I have the crème fraîche from Normandy, of course, but you can find some delicious one near where you are. So to start off, we're going to preheat the oven. So I put it on at 220, which I believe is around 425 for the Americans. So that we need the oven to be really hot for when we're gonna put the chicken in it. Very important little note is that the chicken must be at room temperature. You don't want to put it directly from the fridge to the oven, because I think basically all of the flesh will sort of harden. So you need it to be really at room temperature. So basically mine has been out for about an hour or so, and I just covered it with a cloth. So it's room temperature. And I'm going to put some water to boil for our potatoes. If you have any questions at all, don't hesitate to send me emails or write to me on Miss Maggie's Kitchen, and I'll be happy to answer your questions. I like to put the potatoes directly into the cold water and to let the water boil with them. That's really up to you. So I put the potatoes in the water. We're gonna turn this on, and they're gonna cook for about 15 minutes. I'm gonna add some salt to it as well. There you go. So you'll see the way I cook is very simple. Easy recipes that are very family style. Things that you'll find from the seasons and everything. I want everyone to be happy in the kitchen and not stressed. Something that you can do on your own, that you can do with kids. I love cooking with my boys, so don't hesitate to try it out with family members as well. It's a good time to do so. So this is cooking, that's fine. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take care of our chicken. And my little secret for the best roasted chicken ever is to massage the chicken. I know it sounds a little strange to you, but basically, when you go and have a massage and you get oil put on your skin and you get a nice rub, your skin is really hydrated and your flesh is relaxed and everything. So this is sort of what we want to do with this chicken before we eat it. We want it to really relax and so that it stays really well hydrated. You want it to and crispy at the same time on the outside. You want to massage it for a little bit. So just put some olive oil, okay, and then basically we massage it. So you have to really sort of get it to every little part of its little body, okay? Don't forget the sides. You can even go a little bit on the inside. And I feel like it's really good as well to, because we're gonna add salt afterwards to it, but it's always best to add all of this now, because then the salt will really, stick to the flesh because of the olive oil and then the lemon juice that we'll put on it. So you give it a nice little back rub. There we go. Have a little cloth that I call like sort of my little dirty cloth that I use during while I cook like this, so I don't have to wash my hands all the time. Plus, the olive oil is also really good for your skin. But well, I do it so I don't have to go and clean my hands 10 times. We're gonna add salt. Really sort of rub it in. Okay. I'm gonna put it on the other side as well. Voila. Perfect. Voila. I'm gonna put a little lemon juice on it. So I'm gonna put about see how juicy it is. It depends. It could be a half a lemon or a total lemon, but let's see how juicy. I think since this chicken's so big, I think we're gonna put one full lemon juice on top. This one we can put inside. Voila. Put it inside as well. Good. I'm going to put this here, maybe put a little pepper on it. You could add more later as well too. And we're going to put some garlic inside because the garlic will really bring up some nice flavors. So what I like to do is basically take it, the whole head, and cut it in half. One half of it I'll sort of put into pieces inside with the skin. If people like, if you love garlic, then you can always, you know, have them, you know, when the chicken is cooked and sort of puree them, and it's delicious. Put it on a little piece of toast with a little olive oil. And the other half I'm gonna stick over here, okay? And I'm gonna do that with another one. Except this time, I'm gonna keep this half here, and the other part I'm gonna keep for my mashed potatoes. Next is herbs. So I have some thyme here. I wish you could smell it. It smells so fresh and divine. I'm gonna put some thyme and some rosemary inside the chicken as well. I'm gonna add some olive oil to just to the garlic head so they don't burn, but they really cook well. Sort of rub it in. Because the oven's really, really hot right now. I always like to start it off really hot like this, and then we'll lower the temperature a bit later. I'll guide you through it. Up, ready to go in the oven. So we're gonna let that cook for about 20 minutes. In 20 minutes, I'm gonna open the oven, flip the chicken over, close it up again, and let it cook that way again on high heat for another 20 minutes. And then we'll lower the heat, okay? We'll be back. So while our potatoes and our chicken are cooking a little bit, we're gonna prepare the infusion with the sour cream for the mashed potatoes. You see, it's so good and delicious. So basically, you take the sour cream and put it in a little pan like this, okay? Up. Voila. To this, we're gonna add butter. It's about 100 grams of butter. Okay, I know that sounds like a lot, but it's gonna make it so nice and rich and delicious. We're gonna add garlic to it. So the other half of head that we had. And some herbs. So this time I'm gonna use the oregano, some thyme again, and some rosemary. I'm gonna use three. You could use other herbs, but depending on what you have at home, what you have on hand, such as sage. It's delicious with sage as well. basically anything. I guess you can use, you know, basil or others. So put it all like this, okay? I'm gonna take a spoon. I'm gonna put a little, just a little up salt and I'm gonna put it sort of on low heat, okay? And it's gonna melt. I'm gonna sort of make sure that the butter melts really well into it all, okay? Making sure the whole thing doesn't boil too much. You want it to start sort of like having little bubbles and everything, but you don't want it to boil too long at all. And this is gonna be the magic potion for your mashed potatoes. You'll never want to do them ever again another way because it's so good. So let that melt a little bit. I'm going to check on the potatoes. I think they'll be almost ready. Yeah, they're perfect. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna strain these, 1 second. Perfect. Sorry. They're really hot before we take the skin off, okay? So I'm gonna let these hang out over here, not too far from the window. Look, the butter's melting. Sort of a really very rich sort of a cream that we're making here. But it's really worth it. Put it inside. Basically what I do is I put the, you know, the bits and pieces of garlic like that, but before I'm going to mix it with the mashed potatoes, I'll remove the garlic, I'll remove the herbs, anything that's sort of like whole, I'll take out of the sour cream. I just really want it sort of to infuse the whole mixture. And then you don't have to eat it if you don't like it, don't worry. But it's good for you. Very good for your health. We let that sit for a little while. And then once it's completely melted, we'll let it sit and infuse for about like 10-15 minutes with the herbs in it before we remove them, okay? So I'm gonna start, let me get a little, put it in here for now. What I'm gonna do is take off the skin. I just do it with my knife. I don't know if you have, you know, better techniques. It's a little hot though, still. It smells really, really delicious in the kitchen. I'm just gonna turn over the chicken. Like we said, it's been 20 minutes. See, the other side needs to get golden as well too. So we put it back in there for another 20 minutes. And while that happens, we're gonna take care of the rest of the potatoes so we can get the mashed potatoes done. And add the juices to it. After the 20 minutes of the cooking time now for the chicken, I'm gonna add some lemons to it. Just to bring a little extra juice to it all. If you feel like your chicken is too, if there's not enough juices for you, add maybe half a glass of water or so. But usually the juices, the natural juices of the chicken and the fats and everything will really form a nice mix with the lemon. But the skin off. They're a little warmer now and I can handle them without burning myself. There are other recipes you'd like to see in English, because everything that I do right now has been in French. Definitely let me know. Don't hesitate to send me an email or a message on Instagram, and I'll be happy to do more content for you in English. Two more. Easy with the skin, it's thin, it comes right off. It's running away from me. So I put them all in the dish that I'm going to use for the mashed potatoes. I'm going to take the this is something I love to use to go out fishing for the things inside. Basically, up. I'm gonna drip and put it in a little bowl. I'm gonna get as much and not lose too much of the cream. Get all the garlic out. Nice little one here. Voila. It's becoming a little messy, but it's gonna be delicious. Okay. Oh, I'm gonna taste a little bit. It's perfect. Gonna mash these together. Do a little push with this already, and add so you want to be careful. You can also do it if you don't have this little thing. You can also do it with a fork.
C'est parti.
Alright, so I'm gonna add the rest of the cream to it. Really mix it all up. What we're gonna do is before, so this is something that you can, what I meant to say is that this is definitely something you can prepare in advance, because you're gonna reheat it in the oven. So you can do it the day before, you can do it the morning of, I reheat it in the oven afterwards. So the potatoes are gonna continue to cook with the sour cream, butter, and all of the nice flavoring of the herbs and garlic. What's important here is for you to also add the salt and pepper that you like, according to, you know, what you prefer. It's a little bit different for everyone. It's very personal. So it's good to taste and to see. There we go. I'm just gonna let it be like this for now. Okay. Perfect. I might just add a little pepper on top. Perfect. And I'm gonna let it sit while the chicken is still cooking. And speaking of the chicken, I'm gonna turn it over again. I'm just gonna rinse my big fork. Up. And gonna turn it over one more time, and we're gonna bring down the heat of the oven. Turn it over. Bring down the heat to 180, which is about 350 US. I'm gonna cut up some slices of lemon because I love lemon everywhere. And so I'm gonna add some slices of lemon in the pan. Let's make it for two. And produce more juices for your chicken. Voila. Back in. And now we're gonna let that cook for about another 40 minutes or so. And then it should be okay. We'll check on the chicken to see if it's ready. See you in a bit. Alright, it's time to put on the final touches for our mashed potatoes. So we're gonna take about, 10-15 grams of butter that we're gonna melt very softly. So put it softly, and I put the other oven on the grill mode, okay? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put some melted butter on top of the mashed potatoes. And then we're gonna put it in the oven under the grill mode for about, depends on your oven, but for like 5 minutes or so. And so the top will become all sort of like golden crunchy. And then the inside, since it has all of the sour cream and the butter and stuff, will remain really, really sort of nice and moist and savory. And I promise you'll never want to eat mashed potatoes differently. I'm gonna make sure this is melted. Our chicken is looking good, nice and golden. We're ready to set the table, have a nice dinner as a family, or lunch, depending on where you are. Almost melted, I'm doing it very softly above the fire like this. Little flames. See? It's perfect. And what I like to do is to sort of like do like a painting. So I put tons of hot melted butter like this, and I go around and I do it in little swirls on top of my mashed potatoes. Do the designs that you want, little waves or other. There we go. Perfect. I'm gonna put this in the oven. So it's a grill mode, okay? I think everything's ready. The smells, the kids are asking me when are we going to eat, so let's go check it out. Ah, the chicken is perfect. Perfect, perfect, and golden. Take it out. And I'll show you my little trick, because as you can see, the herbs really sort of roast and dry up as well. So right before I serve the chicken on the table, I like to have some, I'm gonna keep just a little bit for my, hold on. for the mashed potatoes. But the rest, I sort of put it all together and I put it back in the chicken. That way I have fresh herbs. It's a little trick. Up, whoop. And take the other one out. If it's ready, yes it is. Perfect. And you'll see how golden and beautiful. So up, the butter on top. You need to let it sort of dry up for a little bit because right now the butter is still sort of like boiling hot. And then see how it sort of creates this little crust, golden crust on top. And I'll show you, I'll take a spoon. Just to show you. See, it sort of like creates this little crust on top. And it's really, really delicious. And what I like to add here as well too is little herbs here and there. So you could add thyme, or you could put rosemary, or if you use sage, put some some sage flower leaves or flowers on it. There you go. You're ready to join our table. I'm waiting for you in Normandy. See you soon. Thank you. Bye bye.